So I'm not saying that we shouldn't like nice things, because I like nice things. But I realize that the people that go after things and stuff usually don't become massively successful. I discovered that those people who were successful, what they all had in common was they got to the core. So I need you to do me a huge favor. I'm about to say something to you, and I need you to go with me, right? And this has absolutely nothing to do with religion. Somebody asked me about my faith when we were in the VIP. Listen to me, this has nothing to do with religion, right? But my life changed when I joined the church, right? Please hear me. And what happened when I joined the church is that they introduced me to these things called the Ten Commandments. And what was crazy about the Ten Commandments, crazy, y'all, that's how I blew up. And what the commandments did for me was it gave me a set of core values that I never had before. I'm not big time. I'm no better than you. We all the same. We all got vices. We all got struggles. We all got stuff we dealing with. So when I get, listen to me, I don't know, I was 17 years old, joined the church. All I know is when I got those commandments, guess what it did for me? It gave me, I was traveling with no direction. And all of a sudden, now I got some core values to live by. The reason why some of you can't blow up is because you have no, like you don't operate from your values. You operate from money. You operate from your feelings. You operate from stuff. You don't understand why you can't get to the next level, because you don't have a value system, and people know you weak and you don't stand for nothing, and that's why they don't want to associate with you. That's why when they go to the next level, they're not trying to take you with them. So I'm telling you, if you want to blow up, you need core values. My core values say you're smarter than me, but you will not outwork me, which is why I get up at 1:30, 2 o'clock. For real, do me a favor, principles over feelings. It's not about how I feel. What's the principle? How many of you right now, let's just be 100. I want you to be real with me. How many of you can say in this room, E.T., I've not mastered that yet. I'm still like, my feelings get the best of me, and I'm not, like my principles don't reign supreme. I must be honest and say I'm being led by my feelings a lot of times. We're gonna fix that, right? Make a vow to me, it's not hard. We're gonna fix that. Because once you go with your principles over your feelings, you're gonna be good. Like, I don't really get into boxing now, but Mayweather, like, I don't really get into boxing like that, because I'm an old school heavyweight fighters. But I watch Mayweather and I'm like, I see how they get him. I see, because he don't be hitting nobody and hurting nobody, right? But what he does is he does the same exact thing. He grabs you, bop, bop, you gotta stop, bop, bop, he grabs you, bop, bop, bop. And what happens is after about 5-6 rounds, you get what? You get frustrated. And as soon as you get frustrated and you get in your feelings, what happens with your boxing technique? It's out the window. So all he does, I only watch one fight of this guy, because it's too long for me. The people be dancing. And I said, I see what my man is doing. He gets you frustrated. And as soon as you get frustrated, you lose your technique and he just come in, blah, 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 and just get his points and go back. Yeah, so. And is undefeated because he doesn't go into his feelings. He sticks with his principles. And if you would get to a place where you'd stop letting people and things take you into your feelings and take you off your game plan, if you would stick with your principles, you would see yourself reach success more than you've ever seen it before.